this SwageLock how-to video. Here's what you'll need to perform the procedure shown in this brief video. Two open-ended wrenches, or one open-end wrench and a vise, a SwageLock gap inspection gauge, a marker. The SwageLock tube adapter is designed to complement the SwageLock tube fitting and allow fitting-to-fitting connections. It connects to a SwageLock tube fitting in much the same manner as a tube fitting connects to tubing. This video focuses on the manual assembly of the 1-inch and under tube adapter. SwageLock tube adapters can help eliminate difficult alignment problems and reduce inventories. Install the end connection opposite the tube adapter first. Insert the tube adapter into the SwageLock tube fitting. Make sure that the tube adapter rests firmly on the shoulder of the tube fitting body and that the nut is finger tight. Mark the nut at the 6 o'clock position. Marking the nut at 6 o'clock leaves no doubt as to the starting and ending positions. While holding the fitting body steady, tighten the nut 1 1/4 turns to the 9 o'clock position. For 1/16, 1/8, and 3/16 inch, and 2, 3, and 4 millimeter tube fittings, tighten the nut 3/4 turn to the 3 o'clock position. Tube adapters 1 inch and under are gaugeable using the SwageLock gap inspection gauge. On initial installation, the SwageLock gap inspection gauge assures the installer or inspector that the fitting has been sufficiently tightened. To use the gauge, position it next to the gap between the nut and the body. If the gauge will not enter the gap, the fitting is sufficiently tightened. If the gauge will enter the gap, additional tightening is required. A benefit of using SwageLock tube fittings and tube adapters is their ability to be disassembled and reassembled many times while retaining the leak-tight seal. Always depressurize the system before disassembling a SwageLock tube adapter. Prior to disassembly, mark the tube at the back of the nut. Mark a line along the nut and fitting body flats. Use these marks to ensure that you return the nut to the previously pulled up position. Insert the tube with pre-swaged ferrules into the fitting until the front ferrule seats against the fitting body. While holding the fitting body steady, rotate the nut with a wrench to the previously pulled up position, as indicated by the marks on the tube and flats. At this point, you will feel a significant increase in resistance. Tighten the nut slightly. Do not use the SwageLock gap inspection gauge with reassembled fittings. Also, do not mix or interchange parts with those of other manufacturers. Visit SwageLock.com for additional product information. Thank you for watching. We will continue to develop videos like this to help you get the job done. Get more information by watching our other videos or by contacting your authorized sales and service center.